Namaste all. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Artificial intelligence and machine learning is playing a major role in every developing as well as developed nation. If you take the critical infrastructure of any country in this world, you know, is the artificial intelligence is playing a major role in electric grids, in urban smart cities, in urban development, in signaling processing, in tracking the criminals, or on the banking and financial side. So it's like it's playing a major role. Example, if you take a banking and personal financing, you know, the mobile checks, check deposits, or if you take the flights, you know, the autopilot mode, or if you take the ride sharing intelligence in various ride sharing applications, or if you take shortening the text, I mean, you know, there's a lot of computational power is happening on the background with help of artificial intelligence and machine learning. And if you look into the search emails on a daily basis, there also we are using the search filters. It is automatically filtering. So the effort, the complexity is completely taken over by the machines with help of artificial intelligence as well as machine learning. And we are doing our daily activities in a most easiest way. And predicting the searches also, because, you know, human has a limitation of thinking power. But using the artificial intelligence and machine learning, we are basically getting more recommendations, more predictions, and trying to understand the data in a better way. As you know, after this 4G, 4G old, and 3G, 5G is also coming, there's lots of trillions and billions of data, even terabytes of data, I can say, is getting processed on a daily basis. And our mobiles become like a beast, and it became like a supercomputers. So the computational power and the sensors data, you know, the video information, audio information, I mean, you know, vast type of data are getting captured from various formats, and some machine needs to process this and then compute it and convert this into a meaningful format. So this is where I see the potential for Python. If you compare Python with C++, both are like amazing languages, whereas C++ supports the OOPS based concepts but not a computational based, you know, for computing for hours and days continuously, you know, you need a OOPS concepts along with the scripting technologies. So basically Python has that kind of a capabilities. It combines the OOPS as well as the scripting capabilities in a same editor. At the same time, it's an operating system independent. So you can write code in one particular operating system with minor changes. You can run and execute that code in various other operating systems as well. So transfer of code from one machine to another machine, or from one platform to another platform, from one operating system to another operating system is very easy. Along with that, if you see, it has a beautiful libraries in place like Pandas, TensorFlow, Keras. You know, all these libraries are helping developer and reducing the development time. So you can create business applications with less effort. And Python is kind of an English based coding language. You know, as long as you know English, writing Python code is very simple, easy to understand, and easy to you know, compile, because it doesn't need a pre-compilation every time. So that's another beauty of it. And it has amazing charts, plots, and better visualization, you know, which is very important. So combining all this together with other languages, like if you take any other language, you know, you can use a C# code or a Java code or a JavaScript code or any Go language code or any fourth generation languages code, you can combine that with Python. That's the beauty of Python. And big companies like Google, Yahoo, and various other big companies, and all ride-sharing apps, they all are using Python. And if you go towards interesting thing like in Facebook, the identification of the photos and all those face recognition technologies all are driven by artificial intelligence and machine language. And lots of object recognition within photographs or within videos are done by artificial intelligence and machine technologies using this Python libraries. So that's where I see the scope. And along with that, I see that in India, lots of investments are coming, and India is going to be a Vishwa Guru. So I see all the students and faculty can play a major role in this. And Python is our friend, and Python can basically take us to the next level, where we can play with trillions or terabytes of data. And at the same time, we can convert that into a meaningful dashboards. So I request every student and faculty to learn the artificial intelligence, machine learning, as well as computational data, along with cyber security, with help of Python, because Python is a kind of a mother of all these advanced technologies. Even you can write amazing simulations, games also using Python platform. So I recommend everyone to use this. Thank you for giving me opportunity. Thank you. Namaste.